Listen now. We were talking about some gross anatomy of ruminant stomach. Okay? Mainly the major part, which is rumen. So grossly we understand they have grooves, and internally, externally they have groove, internally they have pillars. Point is that. Okay? When you look on the more deep inside the rumen, you will find what? They have a structure which is called papilla, which is called, you know, if you go deep in histology, you will find they are actually villi. They are papilla. This is papilla which are found on the tongue and other part of the region of the mouth. They are actually to increase the surface area. One of the function of rumen is absorption. One of the function of rumen is
absorption.
So structurally they have many papilla. If you go on the reticulum, on the reticulum, this reticulum is actually, if gross anatomically, the most cranial part, the most cranial part of compound stomach is reticulum. Because reticulum, the most cranial part is the reticulum. Here, so your reticulum is located more cranially toward the diaphragm. And here you have lungs, definitely heart here down, okay? But this is demarcated by diaphragm. Point is that most cranial part, if you open abdominal cavity, you will find is reticulum. And if you compare to the rumen, they are on the ventral side. They are on the
ventral
side. They are on the ventral sides. Point is that technically there is no clear demarcation between rumen and reticulum. If you're looking on the internal structure of rumen and reticulum, externally they have a groove. Externally they have a but internally, if you will find, you will not find any proper demarcation between rumen and reticulum. The demarcation, the differentiation is that they have a special arrangement of mucosa. They have a special arrangement of the mucosa. The mucosa of the reticulum is made togetherly a special arrangement which is look like. That's why they have another name. They are also called as histologically, this mucosa of the reticulum and the mucosa of rumen is same. They both have what? Listen, non-glandular. Actually, they have cratinized, stratified squamous epithelium. But the arrangement of mucosa is different. Here we have papillas. Here we have the special arrangement, which is called
honeycomb.
You know, this arrangement of the reticulum is much important. Is much important. Reason is that when the food is enter here from esophagus, food is enter from the
esophagus,
the heavy parts of the food, if there is some metal or anything heavy, grains, they directly drop into the
reticulum.
They directly drop into the heavy particle of the food directly drop into the
reticulum.
You know, if there is a very clinical important thing is here, we know a disease which is called hard wear, a condition in ruminants, large ruminants. If you are, you know, they are not a careful when they are eating.
Yes.
Cows are not a careful. They are just grabbing grass and putting directly into the esophagus from the oral cavity. So if there is a needle, a sharp object, something, this will drop here into the
reticulum.
Because of this such arrangement, because of there's such arrangement, this will trapped here. This will not go further. This will trap here. But you know, this stomach this rumen reticulum, they part, they also have after mucosa, sub mucosa, they have turica muscularis. They have, that means they have ability to contract. They have GIT mobility, a term, you know. They have some role, muscles have some role in contraction. So this structure can contract. So if there is metal here, if there is metal here, because of their location, because of their location, cranially and near, we have here lungs, we have here between his. So because of contraction, sometime this sharp structure, a knife or needle, can penetrate into the pleural cavity, pericardial cavity. So if this happens, this condition or trapping of metal, this is called hard wear condition. Okay? So there is a lot of way to the tackle this hard wear conditions. Okay? Next, Roman reticulum, we have abasm. Abasm, this is a small part. This is a small area of the stomach, mostly round or bean shaped, especially in goat, or round or bean shaped externally. When you open this internally, you will find what? They have a leaf like arrangement or paper like, page like arrangement of lamina. Okay, that's why they are called book stomach. Still, I want to tell that Roman reticulum or abasm, they are non-glandular. The histologically, they are much similar. They are much similar. The mucosa is similar. The point is that they have different arrangement. They have different arrangement of the mucosa. Here, you know, I want to, some books still write this area is rumoreticulum because they do not have a proper differentiation. There is a slightly fold, which fold is also called as rumoreticular fold. A fold which make a sub differentiation between rumen and reticulum. So up to here, reticulums actually have a opening, orifice you can call, into the abasm. This abasm have a large paper-like lamina. That's why they are sometimes called as book stomach. They are sometimes called as book stomach. They also play a major role in absorption. They also they also do the swing function to, you know, to press something. They can absorb a lot of material. From here, there is an opening into the abomasum. Have same arrangement like stomach, simple stomach. We have what? Pyloric region, fundic region, and cardiac region. Clear? So, listen again carefully. If you are approaching compound stomach of cattle from the left side, you will find the abdominal cavity is 80% covered by rumen. 80% covered by rumen. This is a larger part. And rumen is further divided into large sacs. And they have many grooves on their surface. And if you look internally rumen, you will find they have pillars and they have many papillas. Clear? The next portion, which is actually reticulum, this reticulum is sometimes similar with rumen, but they have a different arrangement internally of the mucosa. And grossly, they are more cranial. This is a round or bean shaped structure, which is called abasm, a third part. This have book page like arrangement. The final part, abomasum, is
simple stomach.
Have glandular region. They can produce gastric juice. It's clear? Up to here is clear?
Yes,
okay. Other one. be here. Okay. Now, lastly, we will just look at a little functional story about a ruminant stomach. A very basic concept about the functional role of ruminant stomach. After having some gross anatomy and basic idea, now we will look into a very, very, very basic idea. You know why ruminant animals are called ruminant? Yes, they do. Rumination. So we will have a very quick look on the rumination. Very, very quick. Okay? You know, if somebody asks you define rumination, can you define? How? Well, please, this is called regurgitation. This is also some type of regurgitation. Yes.
The whole process, remastication, regurgitation.
Actually, rumination is a complete cycle. Rumination is a complete cycle. This complete cycle have four phase. This complete cycle have a four phase. For example, if you look on the number one phase, which is number one phase? Regurgitation. What is the phase number two?
Remastication.
The third one is
resalivation.
Fourth one is redeglutination. What is that? Ruminant animal have compound stomach, mean they have one chamber which is called rumen, and they have two abilities to perform of rumination, which is important for their survival. If you look here, esophagus opening into rumen, a large rumen we are drawing here. If this area is somehow is reticulum, then here we have opening here, which is, it's clear, this we know already some of things very well. You know, it's the habit of animals, the grass eating animals, the ruminants, okay, they quickly grab the grass from the ground and introducing, swallowing that grass. You know, they are doing deglutination. They are doing, just deglutination. They are doing also salivation. A partially mastication. These phases are occurring, you know. This, you know, ingestion, the term ingestion, introducing. So, what is happening here? The food from the oral cavity. This, you can call this is bolus, okay? This will enter into what?
Rumen.
This will enter into? Rumen. This, normally what happen, if there is something is heavier, it will go down into the?
Reticulum.
But, the grass, the animal mostly eat, you know, hay. Okay?
Yes.
Grasses, they are light. So they will come into where? They will come into the rumen. Point is that this area, the rumen, the epithelial of rumen hold lot of microorganism. lot of microorganism. These microorganisms actually are bacteria and protozoa. Mainly they are bacteria, about 80%, and 20% of protozoa. 20% are protozoa. Point is that, you know, this is the major point. That's why animal have a such large rumen or a stomach, because the ruminants, the mammalian species, they are not able to digest cellulose. And the grass, you know, this is plant cell wall have cellulose. What they are eating? They are eating in other sense cellulose. And they do not have ability to the digest the cellulose. This is somehow problem. So here, this area, this microorganisms, they have this ability. They have. These microorganisms will perform fermentation. Will perform a biochemical reaction, which is called as fermentation. With the help of these bacteria, your grass or your food of animal eating bolus will be the cellulose or this complex sugar. They will be converted into volatile fatty acids. We have special acetic acid here. So point is that here is the mastication, salivation, deglutination, then introduce here rumen. We have bacteria which do fermentation and produce volatile fatty acid. You know, this rumen is also called fermentation tub or wet. You know, these bacteria are anaerobic. This is the ideal condition for fermentation. These bacteria can survive without oxygen here. So, because of this area, this is a natural fermentation tub is located in the compound stomach of animal. That's mean, because of this structure and because of this population of bacteria, they can digest grass. So, this up to here, we have fermentation. We have and we also have a lot of production of what? Carbon dioxide and methane gases, production of, because of this bio, you know, this volatile fatty acid, they are major energy source for cattle. They are major energy source for ruminant animals. Even some of these fatty acid are also animals sometimes use for fat synthesization in milk. Okay? The animal who is produce milk, they can use some sort of this fatty acid for the fat milk, for the milk fat. Point is that this is your food cycle, okay? Food cycle of the ruminants. Here we have salivation, mastication, deglutination. Come here, we find a group of warrior which are microorganisms. They help animal to the breakdown of the grass for fermentation, okay? And they are producing volatile, which is a major energy source of. What happened next? You know, this food, which is partially digested food, have another term for this now. This food is now will known as cud, which known as cud. This cud or this food will go into the where?
Reticulum.
Will go into the reticulum. In reticulum, if there is small or light molecule, they can absorb or pass on, okay? But still, you know, there is the role of what? Role of nervous system. Role of nervous system. Nervous system will generate a reflex action.
Reflex action.
With this reflex action, there the cardia will be open. The cardia, you know, the what is cardia? What is cardia? Here we have sphincter muscle on opening of esophagus. The cardia will be open, and this, and with the contraction of the reticular muscles, contraction of
reticulum.
This is the reticulum, you know. Reticulum have anybody have four layers. Which one? Mucosa, submucosa. This muscularis will help to the contract of reticulum. So when this contraction occur of the reticulum, and with the help of reflex action, this cardia open, this food will throw into the esophagus. Here no will be generation of antiperistalsis movement. This antiperistalsis movement do what? They'll move this food from stomach to oral cavity. The movement, the backward movement of cud or food from stomach to the regurgitation. The movement of food from reticulum to the oral cavity is called as, this is happen with the reflex action, okay? This will come here, up, no, here, look here. The next step, you know, there is two step happens together, remastication and resalivation. Remastication and a cow can produce up to 200 liter, 100 to 200 liter saliva per day. Okay? So, there is remastication. Cattle have a good group of teeth and have a lot of saliva. So, there is remastication and now this food will come back, okay? This food will to the where? An esophagus. So this is called redeglutination. This is called redeglutination, and this will come into go into, you know what? This cycle. Start from here, okay? Come into rumen, reticulum, back esophagus, back oral cavity, again up esophagus, reticulum. This story is called as
rumination.
This cycle is called as
rumination.
Point is that these your stomachs, for example, reticulum, rumen predominantly, this rumen, with the help of tunica muscularis, they have ability to
contract.
You know, there is a continuous contraction of rumen. There is, you know, in one cycle of contraction of rumen is occurring within a 2 to 3 minutes, okay? They are continuously contract. You know, I can tell you, if there is animal on the backside, there is a depression, you know, near lumbar area and near to the pelvic area. There is a depression. On live animal, there is a depression inside. This depression is called paralumbar fossa. This depression is called? You can put your hand on paralumbar fossa. You can put your hand on and you can feel the contraction of rumen. Why this contraction is important? Because this rumen have lot of food here. Lot of? So they, with the contraction, they mix the food. They mix the food. And also they push the food toward the
reticulum.
The reticulum also have contraction. They pull this food to the esophagus. Toward the? Toward the oral cavity. So in other sense, for rumination, there is the role of contraction of reticulum and rumen for the purpose of
rumination.
One thing is another happened during rumination. We have a lot of production of gases. We have lot of production of gases. For example, you know, 0.5 to 1 liter per minute gas can produce. 0.5 to 1 liter per minute. During this phase, a gas can produce. And carbon dioxide is 60 to 70%. The total gas produced during this, carbon dioxide is 30 to 40% is
methane.
30 to 40% is methane. Point is that, listen again carefully. This rumination procedure, if taking count biochemistry, we have to think of this, the result of this procedure. What? We have volatile fatty acid, which is the energy source which animal need deadly, okay? And we have gases. So this is a problem, you know, if you see on the any rumen of animal, the rumen of animal will be have this top area of rumen, dorsal area, this dorsal area will be completely filled with gas, because gases are light, because gases are light. So point is that we need a mechanism to get rid of these gases also. We need a mechanism during this rumination. We need a mechanism to get rid of. There is a term which we call eructation. This is called eructation. This eructation, this term actually used for, this is known as the removal of gases from stomach via esophagus. Via
esophagus.
Into where? Into lungs, yes. That's right. Someone has makes, you know, let me tell you, major portion of gases. What happened here? Look here. You know, this dorsal surface of rumen have a special type of receptor, which is mechanoreceptor. These receptor actually detect what? They detect the gases in the rumen is high. When go up, they detect these gases. There is a reflex action occur again. This reflex action will open what?
Cardia.
They will open cardia, and there is the close of epiglottis. The closure of
epiglottis.
So these gases go into where? Esophagus to the pharynx. Esophagus to the
pharynx.
And then they will move on to maximum gases. Most of gases amount will go into
lungs.
Some amount can be go into through nose out of the body.
Yes.
Listen again carefully. Yes. During this procedure, we have lot of production of
gases.
So these gases, when they go up, they increase in rumen. There is the receptor. They will detect these gases. They will detect these gases, and these gases will, with the help of some cardiac reflex, this cardia will open, and glottis will close, and these gases will esophagus, from esophagus to pharynx, pharynx to lungs. Some amount can be go into from nostril out of the. You know, there is some people, is a clinical point I can tell you, some people complain sometime your animal milk have some odd taste, or maybe a taste, you know, if you are eating a cattle, a dairy cow with onion, so you will can find that flavor, off flavor in milk. You know why this happened? Because these gases which you are sending into lungs, going where? Again reabsorbing by the blood. If gas will go in lungs, so if there is a gasic some order due to the some specific feed is going to the lungs, that will be absorbed by the blood, and that will be come into the milk. That will come into the milk. So sometimes this, if you are giving some specific feed, they have this problem. And other clinical issue we have, sometimes this mechanism eructation, if fail, if this mechanism failed, what will happen? This first thing is that if this mechanism failed, these gases will be trapped here. These gases will be trapped. There is so many reasons why this happened, but quickly to try to understand. If this mechanism failed, we have what? Trapping of gases here. So if the gas is trapped here, what will happen? This will expand, and this will put extra pressure onto the diaphragm. So if there is pressure on diaphragm, there is a failure of respiration, because the thoracic cavity will not expand and relax. If this will put a pressure, put a pressure on diaphragm, that means diaphragm is connected with thoracic cavity. Thoracic cavity, you have lungs. The animal have
lungs.
So if they put a pressure on, you know, for the normal activity of lungs, you need what?
Contraction.
Expansion and relaxation of thoracic cavity. But if you have a constant pressure, there will be a difficulty in breathing. If you will not tackle this issue, animal can die. Animal can? There is many reason you can use some certain of medicines who can, if you detect early, there is a, this term is called blot, B-L-O-A-T, blot. Well, this condition, this mechanism failed, there is accumulation of gases is called as blot. A tympany also called as
blot.
Tympany. So if this happen, so if you are unable to tackle, animal can die because of the difficulty in
breathing.
The one way is, you can, from the area of paralumbar fossa, you can puncture the rumen and gas will come out. A specific instrument which is called trocar canella. So one point is that. Another point is that you can use some certain medicines. Is clear?
Yes.
Any question up to here? So okay?
Yes.
Thank you very much for today.